Friends, welcome to Bank Exam Cafe. And in today's episode, we are going to discuss few more questions under the episode Important 2 Marks Questions. Friends, this is the 11th part, and previously we have uploaded 10 parts of Important 2 Marks Questions. You can watch all these videos through playlist and you will understand which type of questions can be asked as 2 marks questions and how to deal with such questions. Friends, I also request you to download the PDF of all 2 marks questions videos where the links of all these videos are provided, and also watch all this video. Now let us move to the first question of today's episode. Friends, here is the first question. The HCF of 65 and 117 is expressible in the form of 65N minus 117. Then find the value of N. Friends, here it is given that the HCF of 65 and 117 can be written as 65N minus 117. Then find the value of N. You have to find the value of N. It means it is the HCF only. So first we will find the HCF of 65 and 117. So 117 can be factorized as 2 into 3 into 13. And the 65 can be factorized as 5 into 13. And here you see that the 13 is the common number in both the numbers 117 and 65, and therefore 13 will be the HCF, and so HCF is equal to 13. But the HCF is given in the form of N as in the form of N at 65N minus 117, and therefore 65N minus 117, which is equal to 13. So take 117 to other side, so it will be 65N, so which is equal to 130. 7 and 3, 10, 1, 2, and carry on 1, that is 3, and 130, and therefore N will be equal to 2, because 65 ones are 65, 65 twos are 130, and therefore you have got the value of N is equal to 2. Highlight this and write at the end that the required value of N is 2. Now move to the next question. ABC is a right angle triangle, right angled at C. Let BC is equal to A, CA is equal to B, AB is equal to C, and P is the perpendicular from C to AB. Prove that CP is equal to AB. Now friends, here it is given that ABC is a right angle triangle. I draw the right angle triangle here, ABC. And this is the perpendicular from the vertex C, and here the name ABC, A, B, C is a right angle triangle, right angled at C, and here it is given that let BC is equal to A, this is the BC, that is equal to A, this distance is A. Then CA, this distance is equal to B, this total distance CA is given as B, sorry, CA is given as B, CA, this is given as B, and then AB, that is given as C, this AB distance total is given as C, and P is a perpendicular from C on AB. And you have to find, prove that CP is equal to AB. So friends, first we will take this triangle ACB in triangle ACB. here we can apply the Pythagoras theorem, that is, here we can apply the area formula to find the area of triangle ABC, and therefore area of triangle ACB, that is equal to 1/2 base into height. So if you take this as a base, then height will be AC, so multiplied by BC into AC, and so which is equal to 1/2 into A into B, so which is equal to 1/2 AB. Now we can find the area of triangle ABC in the same way. Area of triangle ACB, that is equal to, if you take AC as a AB as a base, then height will be, this is point D, and this distance is given as P, and therefore here the height will be CD, that is P, and AB will be the base, and therefore it will be again 1/2 base into height, that is equal to 1/2 base, I am taking as AB, that is given as C, so multiplied by C, multiplied by height is CD, that is P. And now from 1 and 2, let this be number 1 and let this be number 2. So from 1 and 2, the area of triangle ACB is equal to 1/2 of AB, and area of triangle ACB is also 1/2 of CB. Therefore from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, here we can write that 1/2 AB, which is equal to 1/2 CP, where half and half will get cancelled, and you will get AB is equal to CP, and it is nothing but CP is equal to AB, and hence it is proved. Now let us move to the next question, that is the mean and the median of 100 observations are 50 and 52 respectively. The value of the largest observation is 100. It was later found that it is 110 and not 100. Find the correct mean and median. Friends, it is given that the mean and median are of 100 observations. There are 100 observations and its mean is 50 and median is 52. Mean is given as 50 and median is given as median, that is given as 52. The value of the largest observation is 100, and it is given that the value of the largest observation is 100, but later on it has come to know that it is 110 and not 100, and you have to find the correct mean and the median. So friends, we know the formula for the mean is that mean is equal to summation of fi xi upon summation of fi. So mean is given to us, that is 50, so it will be 50 is equal to summation of fi xi, and that summation of fi xi we will keep it as it is because we do not know it. Upon summation of fi means the total frequency, and the total observations are given as 100, so it will be upon 100, and so fi xi, summation of fi xi, that is equal to 100 into 50, that is equal to 100 into 50, and so which is equal to 5000. And so friends, here the fi xi, sum of the fi xi is 5000, but the value is 110 instead of 100, one value. So definitely this fi xi will also get increased by 10. Initially it was counted 100, but it was actually 10, and since this is increased by 10, this summation of fi xi will also get increased by 10, and therefore the correct fi xi that is equal to 5010. And therefore the correct mean that is equal to summation of fi xi upon summation of fi, so it will be 5010 divided by 100. So this 0 and 0 will get cancelled and it will be 50.1, and so the correct mean is 50.1. highlight this correct mean because this is the first important step. And now it is asked that what will be the correct median. What will be the correct median? So for that you will have to first see that on what part the median depends. What is median? Median is a middlemost term. If you write something in the increase observations in the increasing order or in the decreasing order, then the middlemost value is called as the median. And the middlemost value does not depend on the highest observation. So the even though the highest observation is changed, it will not make any effect on the median, and therefore median will not change, and so in this case median will remain the same, and that is I think it is given as 52. Yes, it is given as 52. And therefore the correct mean will remain same, and it will median will remain same, and it will be 52. So the median is the middlemost value, remember that. And in mean we take the summation of fi xi, we take the summation of total observations, and therefore even a single observation is changed, it will affect the mean, but it is not in case of median. So friends, now here we will stop, and I hope you must have enjoyed this video. If yes, please like the video, share it with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for watching this video.